You know, I won't be able to convince you, but there's someone else that is able to convince you. There's that little tugging that takes place deep inside our hearts, that as you're sitting there, you begin to get nervous and something is happening inside. You don't know what it is, but something is bugging you. My friend, it's the Holy Spirit.
They don't have that old life anymore. They've been delivered by the power of God.
God is going to be challenging us in a very definite way to go back into those cities in faith, believing that God is greater than any problems that may exist within those cities. How many can say amen?
Remember who we are. We are a people that God has given a mission to.
Once again, we'd like to welcome you to our Victory Outreach International Online World Conference. And we just started yesterday, and what a conference it has been. Just this morning alone, it was so powerful to hear Pastor Ed Morales, and Julie, I was so blessed with the music. Not only Pastor Ed, his preaching, but also the music as well, the worship service.
It was awesome this morning. I was also very, very blessed. And to see him speaking and just everything was just top notch.
I liked the way he presented his shoes. He had some special shoes. And to think
about
it. He
was so unique.
He was always very, very unique. But he actually challenged you, you know?
Yes.
In every service, you would feel challenge every time he spoke. And I mean, he really speaks, and he also lets you have it as well. But we know that it's God speaking to us.
And last night, you were great last night.
Was I?
Oh my gosh.
I wanted to give vision. That was in the early days when we were building our ministry and people needed to know what we're all about. And from there, the ministry started building and building. You know, you could even tell in the conferences, some of the conferences. Look at the conference yesterday that I spoke. It was kind of a smaller conference. And then it got bigger and bigger and bigger. And it's so great to just go back and begin to reminisce.
That was the night that you brought out United We Can.
Yes, yes.
And that was so powerful to see how all of us united, we could win the world. And
amen.
You brought it out so clearly.
Amen. And that's what it takes, us all of us working together. So I know that as this morning, the conference was so powerful, and Pastor Ed, what a message. He's in heaven right now.
Yeah.
He's in heaven rejoicing with the Lord and fellowshipping with the Lord, but his message is still carried on.
Now, if you're speaking Spanish, si habla español, I would like you to go to YouTube page and click on the Spanish link for Spanish translation. You could just go and click it on. It's important, es muy importante que lo hagas ahora mismo. Mi español no está muy bueno, pero.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
And I also have one more little announcement.
Okay, go ahead.
You could download our Victory Outreach International app on the App Store or Google Play. And this is very important because, so as you can stay up to date with everything that's happening, all the upcoming events, and how to give, and give your prayer requests, and videos you can see on there, and the Sunny Argonzoni podcast. There's so much that you receive from that. So I'm gonna ask you, I'll even wait for you right now. Go ahead and do it right now. You could do it right now. Go download our Victory Outreach International app. Amen.
And this morning, we didn't have our morning services, our morning session interpreted, you know, as far as when we presented the morning conference. But tomorrow morning, we'll be having it interpreted into Spanish.
Va a ser en español mañana por la mañana.
Mañana se va a hablar en español y va a caer el poder de Dios. It's going to be interpreted.
Yes.
In Spanish.
I'd like you to start calling your friends right now. Call them and tell them we are on conference time. And go ahead and call them right now. Tell them, come on, we're going to start right now. The worship and everything. You have to make sure that all your friends know about it. Come on, do it right now. Okay, call them right now. Tell them, Sonny and Julie are on right now.
You know, there's so many people that are tuning in to our conference. Not only Victory Outreach. Naturally, we have the Victory Outreach family worldwide that is tuning in. But even beyond that, we've been getting a response from so many people, so many ministries that are tuning in to this conference. You know, they're shut in. Many of you are shut in, and you hear about the conference, and you say, well, I'm gonna tune in to the conference. And I'm so glad that this conference is able to bring blessing also to your life. And I know that in this conference tonight, there's going to be so many that are going to be tuning in to be able to hear David Wilkerson. So just before we go into our 2005, right? World Conference, we want to say a prayer.
Yes.
We want to say a prayer.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, we pray right now that your Holy Spirit will move in a special, special way. Yes. Oh God, prepare the hearts of your people. Open up their hearts so that they may be able to receive. Let the anointing of your Holy Spirit be in everything that is said and done. We ask it in the name of Jesus. And everybody said,
amen.
Amen and amen. So right now, let us all go into our Victory Outreach International Online World Conference 2005. Amen. Let's go right into it right now.
Is Europe in the house? Is Africa in the house? Is South America in the house? Is America in the house? Is the whole world in the house? Come on, hallelujah. We came here from all over the world to lift up the name of the one and only, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I've come to praise your name. Your name. I've come to bow before
Everybody sing it tonight.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Yes, it does.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
And this is why you deserve it.
You deserve it.
Come on, lift your hands if he deserves the glory.
You deserve it.
If he's ever been faithful to you, lift your hands, sing it out.
Belongs to you.
My sing it, Victory Outreach.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Sing it again, my hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Come on, sing it one more time like that.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Sing, you deserve it.
You deserve it.
Lift your hands and sing it out.
You deserve it. You deserve it.
You deserve it, say. Yes, you do, say.
You deserve it.
For everything you've done.
Deserve it.
For everything you're gonna do.
You deserve it.
Hallelujah.
You deserve it. Oh, my God. I just wish that I could sing, that I have a voice, and I could sing. You know, the spirit is willing, but I'm sorry to say the flesh doesn't really cooperate. You know, there's something about the worship, and I think we have some of the greatest worship.
We
have some of the greatest worship teams that, you know, he that forgiveth much, loveth much. And you could really even feel it in the worship services, how many of them that were bound, they have an opportunity to just praise God and be able to just glorify his precious name. Now, you've been receiving, and now's the time for your participation to be able to give. In other words, in every conference about this time, we have offering time. And this is what we have right now. We have offering time. And I would like to challenge you, if there was ever a ministry that you should give to, it is Victory Outreach. We're a vision-driven ministry. It's not just to have a church and we come and we just worship the Lord and go home, but we are vision-driven. We believe God has given us a vision to reach out, not only in one community, but to reach out all over the world. That's why we have different ministries that are all over the world. And even in our conferences, usually at the end of the conference, we launch out people that are going to be launched out in different places around the world. And this takes resources. Let me put it plainly. This takes money. This takes money. And God has been faithful. God has been with us all these years. God has been with us. You know why he's been with us? Because of the faithfulness of God's people. That's why right now we want to challenge you to give. I know that you were touched last night, also this morning. And now is your opportunity to make an investment in the furtherance of the kingdom of God. There's no better investment that you could make than to invest in the kingdom of God. And especially in the ministry of Victory Outreach, a vision-driven ministry of taking the vision, taking the word of God all over the world. And one way that you could give is just not only give offering, but we also have United We Can. That means that people unite together and they give. Many of them give a dollar a day. I think you could even give more than a dollar a day. You know, we challenged people last night. I think that was the beginning of challenging them to give a dollar a day in United We Can. But throughout the years, there's others that have taken the challenge, giving above a dollar a day because they've seen God's blessing upon their lives. And this is what I'm going to ask you to do. I'm going to ask you, if you're not part of United We Can, then I ask you and I want you, and I'm going to challenge you to be part of United We Can. And Julie's going to be telling you how you could give offering, and also how you could be part of the family of United We Can.
Yes, I love to give, and I know you love to give as well. And those of you that are watching right now, there's three ways to give. You can scan your QR code, or you can give through push pay, mail in your giving, or give online. But there's all these different ways that we've made it very convenient for you to give. We had a video for you that shows you a little bit more about giving, but I guess it's not ready right now. But you can give. Give by scanning your QR code, or give through PushPay, or mail in your giving, or give online. But we all should be ready to give. Give unto the Lord. Give through United We Can, because we appreciate everything that you do through your giving.
You know, usually in our conferences, we take the envelopes and we pass them out. And then from there also, we receive the offering and they come back again and we receive the offering like that. But this is one way of giving, especially on online. And everybody knows technology now, especially our young people, the now generation. Some of us are old folk like Julie and I. This is actually something that is new for us, all the technology. But we're getting there. We're getting there, and we're challenging our people to give online. And we see the response of how people are actually giving. Now, you know, the Julie, tell me what's happening over here.
Well, we have an announcement video right now.
Okay.
And we have announcements that
I want you to get excited.
Well, I'm excited, but it didn't come out when I wanted it to, so, but now it's ready.
Okay.
Generosity made simple. Text VOI to 77977. Select the giving link. Enter your amount and gift type. If it's your first time giving, enter your payment details and confirm your gift. Thank you for your generosity. Now we can stay connected wherever you go. Download the Victory Outreach app and stay connected with Victory Outreach International. Get important updates and announcements. Learn more about our ministries. Stay connected with events, prayer requests, and more. Watch the latest video in our media section. Easily share content on social media within the app. Give from your phone in seconds. A convenient way to stay connected.
God's people are not going to go back the same. And then God says, where you said you could not do it, that's the place that I have called you, because you're not going to do it, but I'm going to be doing it through you. There are thousands and thousands of people that have been touched, that have come through the home, that have come to our churches. Not only do we have a local vision, but God is going to send you out, and He's going to send you out, and He's going to send you out, and He's raising us up, and many of you are going to be pastors, you're going to be evangelists. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things become new.
This October, we're coming together, preparing for one purpose, a United We Can effort, Run for Hope, in 12 different locations. Run for Hope is more than just a 10K or 5K run. It's a movement fueled by passion, courage, hope, faith, and inspiration. Join us for this year's Run for Hope of Unstoppable Help. Register today at runforhope.victoryoutreach.org. We are in it to make a change.
How far you've come.
God, we offer, oh God, our lives to you, Lord. And I pray there will be a revival of prayer, a revival of sacrifice, a revival, oh God, of paying the price, oh God, from the young to the oldest, in the name of Jesus. What we need, what we're looking for, is Abishai's of the vision. Protectors and guardians of the calling and the vision of Victory Outreach.
God has given us an overall purpose of reaching the inner cities of the world.
Just before we introduce our special music, we have a choir. It's called the Diamond of Destiny Miracle Choir. And I want Julie just share a little bit about all these women that are going to be in the choir. What is it, a thousand voice choir?
Thousand voice choir. They're Diamonds of Destiny. And these girls, all of them have come out of alcoholism, drug addiction, some of them prostitution, but they're all miracles of God. And we call them Diamonds of Destiny. And when you hear them singing, you see them actually you see their little faces, you can see the gratitude on their faces. It's so beautiful to see.
So let's go right now to the Diamond of Destiny Miracle Choir.
Speechless, Sonny, because this is one of the most incredible manifestations of the grace of God I've seen in 50 years. A tremendous manifestation of the grace of God. And while they were singing, Sonny, I remembered the first time I met you. You thought I was a narcotic agent. That's what you said. You're a narco. You're not a preacher. I quoted enough scripture to him. He knew I wasn't a narco. I came home and I told Gwen, I've got somebody I found on the streets. Could we keep him here? We didn't have a center, so she said, fine, we took him into her home. 3 days, wasn't it? And I had to go into Brooklyn, and I took you along, and he jumped out of the car. And he said, I can't handle it, I'm leaving. And I remember what I told you, I'd rather shoot you in the back of the head then let you go, but I can't hold you. That's the work of the Holy Spirit. and the Holy Spirit had planted a seed in his heart. And I tell you, when I stand and see what's happened since all over the world, Sonny, God bless you and Julie. This is truly, honestly, I say it not flatteringly, but to the glory of God, this is one of the most effective, soul-producing, life-producing ministries on the face of the earth today. And we give God the glory and the praise for it. And thank you for the honor of letting me be called Grandpa. Your sons, your daughters, and all this. But you see, this is all to the glory of Jesus Christ and to none of us. So we're just examples. And all these ladies, these beautiful ladies that were here, I have got to get a tape of that. Get me a tape so I can take it Sunday and show it to Times Square Church. Our people will be shouting all over the place.
Now, that was our 2005 World Conference that we had David Wilkerson, and you heard that beautiful, beautiful choir. Now, there's two reasons why we played this 2005 World Conference. First, it was because be able to hear these women, so dynamic, to be able to share and sing and be able to feel the power of the Holy Spirit in those women that have been delivered. And then also, secondly, is to give you a little bit of history, right, Julie?
Yes, and you could hear Dave Wilkerson, how blessed he was, and how he took you into his home, all those things that he shared. It was so beautiful.
The history of my first encounter with David Wilkerson in the streets of New York City. And this is your history, my history, your history. You could call him Grandpa. Now, we're taking another conference, the 1995. He's preached for us quite a number of times. He's spoken at our conferences, and he's spoken so many different messages. But there's a message that he spoke in our 1995 World Conference that, man, it really touched my life, and it touched the lives of every person that was in that conference. Yeah. Right, Julie?
Yes, it was powerful, powerful. I know that you're going to be blessed as you watch him and as you hear him. It's just a powerful, powerful, timely word.
So we're going from the conference of 2005 to the conference of 1995. Let's go right now and hear the preaching of David Wilkerson.
To give a real warm welcome right now to Pastor David Wilkerson as he comes. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Nikki, it's good to see you with us here tonight, and your wife Gloria right down here. Sonny, I'm the only one getting older. These guys get younger looking all the time. I'm the gray hair now. Wait until Nikki gets gray hair so I can rejoice over it. Oh yeah, I see some coming on both sides there. You're coming along. Sonny's got his dyed. No. Hallelujah. It's a joy to be with you. Don't get ready for a long sermon. I'm not going to preach a sermon tonight. I prayed, God wouldn't give me a sermon. He wouldn't give me something that I'm used to doing and preaching messages and sermons, but I want to share my heart. Take about a half hour and just share my heart, if you don't mind, please. I just got so excited about going back. I got in a car, drove back up in the hills of Pennsylvania, and the camp was no longer a camp, but somebody had bought it. And I drove onto the campground. There was a man standing at the entrance, and I didn't know, but he's the man who bought the place. And he said,
I know who you are. And he said, I think I know why you're here. You want to go back and kneel where you got called years ago, 56 years ago. I said, you're right. And I went back. And I knelt right where he called me 56 years ago. And I still felt the brokenness. The tears just began to flow. And I said, thank you, Jesus. Thank you for touching my life. I sat here literally rejoicing in the Lord, remembering. I was reliving the first days we met Sonny on the streets, reliving and thinking of the miracle of what God has done all this time. But the Holy Spirit said something to me while I was sitting here. It said it's going to take more than enthusiasm. It's going to take more than zeal to win cities. Takes much more than that. I know nobody here is trying to hype it. Nobody is trying to just sing it to pass. Many of you have been delivered from drugs. You've been delivered from alcohol. But has God broken you yet? Have you been absolutely, totally broken in your spirit? Have you been crushed of all self and all pride? Have you been shut in with God and given him that gut cry where it's, oh, God, I don't want anything of flesh. I don't want to do anything in my own power. I don't want to do anything in my own strength because that's hay, wood, and stubble. It's not going to work. The scripture says, Micah 4:10, be in pain, labor to bring forth, O daughter of Zion, like a woman in travail. Now, folks, I went to New York City. God raised up a work. But over the years, so many cities wanted me to come and tell about it, and other teen challenge centers were started, and I became an evangelist and began to preach to thousands all over the world. And I got so busy running, I got so busy doing things for God, building so many things for God. There's nothing wrong with building. We've got to have buildings. I'm building, right? We're doing all kinds of things for God right now in New York. I'm a busy man, yes. But you see, I had allowed the busyness to take me away from that high and holy place of brokenness and contriteness before God. Because when you shut in with God, he's going to break your heart. He's going to tell you his eternal purpose, and he's going to tell you what's on his mind, and you'll come out of your secret closet in his mind, doing his work his way. Then he's obligated to pay the bills and meet everything that's happened. But I got so busy, I tell you, I backslid in my heart. I wasn't running around. I wasn't doing anything wrong, but the brokenness was gone. I could cry, but the real genuine brokenness was gone. There was an emptiness. And a prophet of God, Leonard Ravenhill, gave me a book. Now, I was preaching to thousands every night, but my heart was cold. I was going through the motions. Going through the motions. I could go home from a meeting of 1,000 people being saved and go home back to the motel and laid down on the bed and feel as empty and dry as I could be. Empty. The brokenness was gone. The travail was gone. And Brother Ravenhill gave me a book, and I read it by an old Puritan, and it just broke my heart. And God said, I want you to cancel everything. This was 12 years ago. Cancel everything. Shut down your crusades. You get back to the high and holy place, you get back to where you were. Because, you see, it doesn't matter how long you've lived for God. Doesn't matter how old you are. I can say, well Lord, I've been walking with you for 40 years or 50 years. Shouldn't I be able to just take it easy a little bit? No, the older you get, the harder it is to keep that fire and that brokenness before God. The Lord said, shut it down. And begin to seek my face. And I canceled everything. And I gave myself to prayer. I gave myself once again to that high and holy place. Said, God, break my spirit. I don't want to be doing anything in the flesh anymore. I'm tired of preaching sermons. I'm tired of doing the same thing over and over again. God, you do something in me like you did when I was at the camp meeting when I was a boy. You do it for me once again. Teen Challenge was being blessed. Thousands being saved. But out at once again, I took a whole year off and I just spent it alone crying out to God. And my wife can verify the Spirit of God would come on me with such brokenness. I would groan so much in the Spirit. There was a broken spirit coming and there was a travail like I was giving birth to a baby. And I was giving birth to a baby because that ministry that God is closest to his heart is his baby. That is being birthed. And it has to be birthed through travail. None of you women that are here ever gave birth to a baby without travail unless you had a C-section. And even then, there was pain involved. And there's travail if you're going to have the ministry that is according to his eternal purpose and represents his heart. Now, I'm not preaching you a sermon. I'm telling you what the Holy Ghost is saying and what he said to me and how he had to deal with me. I don't want him to have to deal with you that way. I don't want you to have to go through the pain, the emptiness, and the sadness. And I shut myself in God, and the Spirit of God would come on me, and my wife, wherever she'd be, anywhere, would come knocking on my door in my office and fall down on her face with me and begin to pray. She said, the Spirit of the Lord is so strong in this house. It was just drawing. Anyone who came in the house, it would draw because there was a brokenness. There was a spirit of travail. And if you have brokenness, if you have travail, a third word I want to give you is dependency. Depending on the Holy Ghost for everything. Totally dependent like a baby, where you are not depending on man. Cursed is the man who trusts in the arm of the flesh and not in his God. He trusts in the arm of the flesh. Folks, it was out of that brokenness God birthed Times Square Church. Because soon after that time off with the Lord, I went to New York City to hold a street summer crusade. And I was shocked in the street meetings. Of all the years in New York, I had never seen it so bad. Every night I preached on the street, there'd be one, two, three preachers, backslidden, Pentecostal preachers who'd been saved from drugs, alcohol, back on drugs. Then I went down on 42nd Street, crossroads of the world, and that's the week that Len Bias, the basketball player who had signed with Boston, is going to be one of the best stars in basketball. He had just died of an overdose of cocaine. And every junkie on 42nd Street was about midnight. I was walking 42nd Street. And they were saying, hey, I got the good stuff. I got the stuff that killed Len Bias. And I was so shocked because the commercial was, I got good stuff, it'll kill you. And for all the years I worked with drug addicts, death had been at least one barrier left against anarchy, against giving over to the whole spirit of the devil himself. Now, death is not a barrier, it's the ultimate trip. And I was so shocked. I sat down on a fire plug and began to weep, and I said, God, raise up a church right here in Times Square. If you raise up a church, I'll help, I'll raise money. You've got to find some young man, somebody with the burden, and bring him in here, and I'll come, I'll preach for him, I'll do anything. For 3 days, I walked the streets late at night. My wife was in the hotel, and I walked the streets, and I cried, and I wept. God, raise up a testimony in the middle of this place. And suddenly, I began to realize why I'd spent almost a year weeping and crying and travailing, because I was down in the middle of Times Square, probably 1 o'clock in the morning, just sitting there at Ticketron Island where they buy the tickets. And some guru with a turban came and sat right opposite me. And he says, get out of this city. You don't need to be in this city. And it was the devil himself incarnate in some person screaming at me, get out of this city. And I knew that God was saying something. At that very moment, God said, David, you know this city. You come. You do it. And if you do it, I'll give you one of the best theaters in New York City. You'll never need to ask for money. I will honor you. I will bless you if you'll be totally dependent on me and keep your heart broken. And as you know now, there are some probably 5,000 people call it home, church home. And God has blessed. But folks, I've seen the devil try to literally try to destroy me and destroy that church. We've had demonic teams come and etch our glass doors with all kinds of demonic emblems. They've jumped up on stage trying to tackle me. I've had to have bodyguards. We've gone through every kind of slander there is on the face of the earth, the devil trying to kill it and destroy it. And you say, well, how do you fight that kind of enemy? How do you fight when the enemy comes in like a flood? You fight it the same way he called you. You go into the secret closet and you pour your guts out to God. You cry. Those devils you face that hold your cities and your towns, those demonic powers are so strong, your enemy is stronger than you'll ever be in your flesh. What are you going to do when the devil comes? I'm going to tell you, when you start getting blessed and God starts moving in your church and in your ministry, you'll know when the devil knows you're being successful in the kingdom of God. He'll throw everything out of hell at you. Would you quit trusting in the arm of flesh? Would you just go to God and say, God, if you have called me to this, I want it. If you haven't called it, then don't let me carry it anymore. Let me lay it down. Let me not burden myself, my family, my friends, and my people trying to put on something that God has not birthed in prayer. And if he's birthed it in prayer, let me tell you, let me give you a secret. If you don't hear anything else I've said, hear this, please. Dependency means never having to be disappointed again. God taught me that right now. Let me give you an example with this. I'm going to close in just a moment. We need space just like you do. And for 3 years we've been negotiating on Broadway, 75,000 square feet, a whole city block of 3 floors. And we need it desperately. And I have walked around it and claimed it like everybody does. And I've prayed and I believe God. But you know what? God showed me something. David, you prayed in faith. Total dependency on the Lord is never having to be disappointed again. If God is in it, he's going to do it. If he's not in it, he's not going to do it. So why should I care? I just laid it down. I said, Lord, I fasted, I prayed, done everything I know how. I give it to you. I'm not going to be disappointed if it doesn't happen. I'll go another way. You'll meet it in some other way. Don't get hooked on buildings. Don't get hooked on something that's going to disappoint you. If you're totally dependent on God through prayer and brokenness, you never again in your life will be disappointed. Oh, that's enough. Hold it just a minute, please. Listen. I would just take a few moments. That's all the Holy Spirit is saying to me. God wants to use this ministry in a very special way. Now listen to me, please. Listen to a grandfather. Just hold it. Not a sound, please. Leonard Ravenhill, that great prophet of God who died recently, was a friend of mine. He told me one day, he said, David, preachers don't pray. And I had a hard time believing that. He said, watch in the next meeting what happens when I give an altar call. And he started preaching about preachers who don't pray. They started running, confessing. And I found it out to be true. My wife and I were having lunch with a pastor of a church of 1,000 people. And she turned to me and said, honey, if you don't confess, I'm going to tell him. I thought it was adultery. And I looked at my wife. He said, I'll tell him. He looked at me, said, David, I pastor a church of over 1,000 people. I have not prayed in 1 year. I'm busy. I preach good, but I don't pray. And I want to tell you something, and hear it in the Spirit. Victory Outreach has prayed. You have praying leaders. But if you don't, listen to me, please. I'm warning you. I beg you. If this does not turn completely, totally to brokenness, to every leader, every member of every congregation, you begin to seek the face of God like you never sought Him before with quality time, and you begin to pray and lay yourself out before God. So, Lord, I'm going to give you quality time. Shut off that Babylonian idiot box for a while and get to seeking the face of God. If you don't, it becomes flesh, and it becomes a stench in God's nostrils. It'll look good, it'll sound good, but it won't have the foundation. This work was birthed in prayer. This ministry, Victory Outreach, was birthed when Sonny and his wife got a hold of God and began to weep and travail before God. And they were totally dependent on the Lord. They still are. But He can't give to you that spirit. It has to come from God Himself. You have to have the same experience. And I'm telling you now, if this convention, if all you came was to have a good time and get fired up and get your zeal burning, you're going to miss the purpose of God. God wants you to leave this city. He wants you to leave this convention before the week is over. Crushed, broken, crying out to God for your family, for your unsaved, for your church, for your city, with a cry to this one while I looked him at a broken heart and a contrite spirit. Now will you stand, please? Will you stand? Holy Spirit, please don't ever let me get cold. Holy Spirit, don't ever let me be in the flesh. Don't ever let me stop crying. Don't ever let me get to a place where I can't be moved. Don't let me depend on the flesh or trust in man, but to trust in you, O God, that what you've called into being, you will support. And if we go out and do what you told us to do, you'll stand with us. But, oh God, you won't stand with us in our pride and our self-sufficiency. You'll come and break us and melt us, and you'll commune with us, and out of that communion will come the word, the voice of the Lord saying, do this, do that, go here, go there. And you will lead us and you will guide us by your Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. God, forgive us if we have grown cold. Forgive us if we've become indifferent. Forgive us if we've been phonies, if we've just been playing the game. Forgive us, Lord, if we've just been shouting and not praying. Forgive us, oh God. Now I'm going to give an invitation. Now, please don't come. There's just not enough room for everybody. And nobody here is interested in just packing the place up here. That doesn't mean anything. Don't move unless you're guilty and willing to admit it. I have not been seeking God with all my heart and soul and mind. I'm not a seeker after God. I love Him, but I have not been seeking Him. My heart is not broken. But I want a broken heart and a contrite spirit. Now, don't come. Please don't come. Some of you don't need to come. But you come if the Spirit's calling you. You say, Brother David, that's me. You touched my heart. You said exactly what the Holy Spirit is talking to me about. Please don't come unless the Spirit moves you, because nothing will happen up here then. It won't happen. When you get up here, you get your hands up to heaven, and you get your hands up, cry out to God, and you ask forgiveness. Now come close, because there are, stay within the line. Stay within the yellow line. I want you to lift your hands, and I want you to talk out of your gut right now. Oh God, forgive me for my laziness. Forgive me, Lord, for not seeking You as I should. Forgive me for doing so much good things for You, but not having the quality time to get to know You, to get to know You and to be intimate with You. Folks, I'll tell you what, that's enough. Just stay right where you are. Nobody else move. Nobody move.
I believe this has been a direct message for all of us right now, tonight. God has spoken to us. I mean, there's no clearer way that God could speak than to speak to our hearts through this message. Now, David Wilkerson is at home in heaven, but his message still goes out, that all of us need to come into that relationship with Jesus. You see, it's not just working for Him. More and more, God tells me, it's not just doing a work for me, not going out and just building churches, but I want to have that intimate fellowship with You. That's what God wants. That's what God speaks to me about. It's not so much building Victory Outreach or the ministry of Victory Outreach, but having that relationship with Him. He wants to walk with us. He wants us to talk to Him, and He wants to talk to us. And there's a brokenness. You know, when you feel the Spirit of God, there's a brokenness that takes place within your life. I remember when I first got saved. When I first got saved, I knew that I needed God. I needed a brokenness within my life. And that's what the Lord did. The Lord broke me. It was days that I was praying and broken before the presence of God. I really needed that. I needed to know that God is real and that He has power and that He's able to change my life. In fact, I was so hungry for God that, you know, when you're first saved, you say a prayer the best you know how. And I would say to Him, God, I want to see You. I want to not only walk with You and talk to You, but I want to see You. That's the hunger that I had when I first got saved. And I'm sure that many of you also, when you first gave your life to Christ, so when Jesus came into your life, there was a brokenness. There was the Spirit of God that came upon you. But where are you now? Do you still have that fellowship with Jesus? Are you still broken before the presence of God? In fact, when was the last time that you cried? You know, I love to be a crybaby. Every time I pray, sometimes I come and my eyes all swollen because the Lord has made me a crybaby. When we get broken by the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit is all over you, that's where God is able to give deliverance. That's where the anointing of the Holy Spirit comes upon you. That's when you see miracles begin to take place in your ministry. And you heard it loud and clear that there are many pastors, that go on for years, and many leaders, that spiritual leaders, that go on for years, and yet they don't know how to get a hold of God. They're not broken before the presence of God, or they haven't prayed for a long time. I think if we want God's blessings upon our lives, and I believe that God wants to bring revival to Victory Outreach. I believe it with all my heart. That's why there's a spirit now. There's a spirit of prayer. It's been a whole month that we've been praying 24 hours a day, praying before the presence of God, because we anticipate that God wants to do something great and powerful in our lives and also through our ministry. But it won't happen unless God does it. That's why even in the conferences, when we gather together, it's not just a fun time. It's not just a time of coming and having fellowship, but it's a time where for a week when we come together like that, God wants to deal with us. God wants to do a work. He wants to do a Holy Ghost operation within our lives. And what we have to do is we have to yield. We have to let him do it. Let God be God within our lives. And sometimes you say, people tell me, well, Pastor Sonny, how do you feel about all the great things that have taken place through your ministry? Well, I look back and I say the best is yet to come. What we want to see, what I want to see, is a genuine revival of the Holy Spirit, a spiritual awakening upon our churches and upon our people. I believe it's coming. I think the whole world is going through this problem, this crisis right now, this plague that has come upon us, coronavirus, all over the world. It's not only in one city or in one country, but it's something all over the world. I think God wants to get our attention. And this is where the church is, that we're struggling sometimes. Or right now, we're going through a period of crisis within our churches. We can't even meet together within our buildings. This is a time that we have to yield and let God be God in our lives. We weren't able to come to conference, but right now we're in conference. And the very same way that in the conference God moved by his Spirit, God is moving right there within you, wherever you are watching, wherever you are getting together and watching this conference or being part of this conference, God wants to do the work in you. God wants to break you. God wants to get you on your knees. God wants to do a work in your life. Those of you that need the baptism of the Holy Spirit, God wants to baptize you in the Holy Spirit. Those of you that are not saved or in bondage, God wants to set you free from that bondage. And the only way that it will happen is by yielding your life to the Lord. I think right now, I believe God wants to do the great work in you. Those of you right now that are tuning in, those of you that are by online, you join together in this conference. God wants to do something special within your life. This is God's time. In fact, it was David Wilkerson that he prophesied years ago. He prophesied the very same thing that is taking place today. He prophesied that there was going to be a calamity. There was going to be a crisis that would come. And it would affect New York City, affect the entire world. But then he also said, after this happens, there's going to be a spiritual awakening that's going to come. There's revival that's going to come upon God's people and upon the church. I believe it. I accept it. And I'm accepting it by faith. I'm standing upon the promise of God. So this is the time. Let's get ready for it. Let's get ready for it. And the only way we get ready is by getting in and begin to travail and pray before the presence of God. This is not the time to be cold. If you've been cold and somehow you've been going through the motions, and even if you've been working for him and you've been active for him, but if there's an emptiness inside of you, there's a void inside of you, then you need to be real about it. You need to confess and say, I need God to work in my life. I need a brokenness. I need God. I need another baptism of the Holy Spirit within my life. That's what God wants to do. And I believe that this message of David Wilkerson was for all of us, for the preachers as well. All the preachers. It was for me. It was for you. It was for all of us. That we need to look at our lives, examine our lives, and get our lives right with God. Come to that place that God wants us to be. We want to see great things happen. We want to take the world. But the only way that'll happen is by, first of all, coming into that beautiful relationship with Jesus. Let him do it. Don't you dare try to do it. You can't do it. It has to be God that will do the work. And first of all, he has to do that work within our lives. So I want to say a prayer for you right now. In fact, I want you to pray. Those of you that are in your homes, those of you that are tuning in through the website, through online, I want you to pray for each other right now. I want you to get up and begin to pray for each other. And I'm going to say a prayer, but begin to pray for each other right now. Let God begin to move. Let the Holy Spirit break you right now, right where you are.
Yes,
Lord. Right where you are. Whether you're part of Victory Outreach or not, that doesn't matter. I know there are others of you that you're tuning in right now and you're not part of Victory Outreach. You may be part of another ministry or whatever it is. Right now, God wants to do the work in you as well. God wants to do. This message was for you. This message was for me. This message was for all of us. And this is the time we have to receive it and be open and let God do what he wants to do right now in our lives. So those of you that are in the homes, go ahead and pray for each other right now. As I say the prayer, you begin to lay hands on one another. Let there be a prayer meeting taking place right now within the home. Let the power of the Holy Spirit begin to move within the homes right now. Let God work within you. Confess it right now. If you need to confess it and say, I need God, I need God, I need to pray, I need victory, I need deliverance, whatever it is, let God do it for you tonight, right where you are. You don't have to be in the church building, but right where you are, God will work that miracle for you right now. I'm going to pray. And as I pray, I want you to pray. I want you to lay hands on each other. Some of you need a healing, whatever the need may be. But the most important thing that we need to do is get our lives right with God. Examine ourselves before the Lord. Are we where we're supposed to be with God? And if we're not, then let God do the work right now. Open up your heart. They say, God, break me. Let me travail before your presence. Give me a broken spirit, a broken heart, broken spirit. Right now, break me, oh God. Let your Holy Spirit move in my life. I'm going to pray. You guys begin to pray for one another right now as I say this prayer. Oh Lord, we've been touched tonight. You've moved upon our hearts, oh God. We've heard the message. We've heard the message, direct and clear message. That has been clear and direct for each one of us. Oh, Lord, right now, we examine our hearts, we examine ourselves. And, Lord, we want to be what you want us to be. We want to come into that intimate relationship with you. We don't want to do anything without you, oh, Lord. We want you to be first within our lives. Break us, oh, God. Fill us, oh, Lord. Let us feel your presence. Those of you that haven't felt it, Lord, let us feel it for the very first time or for a long time that we haven't felt it, oh, Lord. Move in our lives right now, I pray, oh, God. Bring deliverance. Give us that hunger once again. Those that have lost their hunger, give hunger to them once again, oh, Lord. Let this be something great. That at the end of this night, they may say, yes, oh God, I'm back again where I'm supposed to be. I'm back again in tune with God. Oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, raise us up, oh Lord, to be part of this great awakening that you want to bring upon the land. Lord, we can't do it by ourselves. Our dependency is on you. And we yield our lives right now to you. We yield our hearts to you right now. That you may do whatever you want to do within our lives. We pray this in the name, matchless, precious name of Jesus. Oh, I can feel his presence right here. Could you feel it right there?
Yeah.
He's right there in your midst. He's right there. The Holy Spirit is moving right there where you are right now. Yeah. So begin to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Jesus is real. We praise your holy name. We praise you, O Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise
the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Julie, I feel there was a brokenness that is taking place right now.
Oh, beautiful.
Isn't it beautiful?
Yes. And the Lord says, a broken and contrite heart he will not despise.
And this is just the second night of conference. We still have tomorrow. We have the next day and the next day. We have some powerful preachers that are coming up. We have Jim Cimbala for tomorrow night. Jim Cimbala from my hometown of Brooklyn. He's going to be preaching. He's the pastor of Brooklyn Tabernacle Choir, Brooklyn Tabernacle Church in Brooklyn, New York. And he's going to be ministering a tremendous, powerful, powerful preacher. And then after that is on Thursday, we have John Hagee.
Yes.
John Hagee from Texas is also a powerful, powerful preacher. He's going to be preaching on Thursday night. And then on Friday, who do we have?
Who do we have on Friday?
Reinhard Bunke. Man, you know, Reinhard Bunke.
I'm still caught up with his spirit.
Reinhard Bunke, one of the greatest preachers, and he's also gone on to be with the Lord, and Dave is up there, Reinhard Bunke's up there, and my God, but the message still goes out. There was one time that Reinhard Bunke preached to how many people? 2 million people.
2 million people, yeah.
In fact, we have a video before we introduce him.
Yeah, we're going to be showing it.
We're going to be showing it, and it's going to be a powerful, powerful preacher, I'm telling. And then in the morning sessions, tomorrow morning, what do we have?
We have David Martinez.
We have one of our elders, David Martinez, who's pastor of San Fernando Victory Outreach. He's also gone on to be with the Lord, but he's going to be preaching in our morning session. So it's going to be also translated into Spanish as well. So we have a whole lineup this week. I don't think anybody's going to be the same. No. They shouldn't be the same.
Right.
I'm getting all excited. I want to start dancing around right now. And I know God is doing something powerful. We couldn't go to a conference, so we bring a conference to you. And you can see I'm all dressed up for conference. I got up. I was today getting ready, and I says, I'm on my way to conference. And I don't know you where you are. You are in conference right now, and we have that conference spirit right now because Victory Outreach is in conference.
Yes.
Amen.
You started getting ready at 3 o'clock this
afternoon. I couldn't wait. I said, I want to go to conference. I want to go to conference. And here I am in conference. And then tomorrow morning again, we'll be in conference. Tomorrow night again, and throughout this entire week. So it's been great. I can't even put it into words. Dave Wilkerson usually speaks longer, but I think he had a direct message that God had put upon his heart. And it's so great to hear that, hear from a man that's been preaching for so many years. To be able to say, yeah, man, imagine he's admitting, I was cold and I was empty. Imagine that, admitting that, you know, that's what you call being humble. That's what you call recognizing, man, I'm just human like everybody else, and I can't do anything without the Spirit of God working within my life. Amen?
Amen.
Is there any closing announcement that you would like to make or anything?
No, I just can't wait to see you again tomorrow morning, and we're going to be hearing David Martinez, and then tomorrow night with Jim Cimbala. It's going to be so awesome. So let's get ready. Get ready for God to speak to us.
And we'll be... When I say see, we'll be seeing them in the spirit, right? You'll be seeing us, but we will be seeing you in the spirit. Amen? So once again, it was so great having you with us today and the second day of conference. And we have so much more that God wants to do. So just stay praying. Just don't, you know, just, it's still early. Those of you that are in California and the West Coast, just keep on praying. Let God do whatever he wants to do there within your homes. Amen. Praise the Lord. Then once again, we just thank you for being with us. It's been a great time together. And may the Lord bless you. And we'll be seeing you again in spirit tomorrow. Amen. Okay, God bless you. God bless you.
Thank you for tuning in today to our live broadcast. You too can also be part of giving right there where you're at, whether you're at home watching or on the go. Simply by clicking on the link in the description below or through our Victory Outreach International app. Let's take a look at how easy it is to give.
Generosity made simple. Text VOI to 77977. Select the giving link. Enter your amount and gift type. If it's your first time giving, enter your payment details and confirm your gift. Thank you for your generosity. Now we can stay connected wherever you go. Download the Victory Outreach app and stay connected with Victory Outreach International. Get important updates and announcements. Learn more about our ministries. Stay connected with events, prayer requests, and more. Watch the latest video in our media section. Easily share content on social media within the app. Give from your phone in seconds. A convenient way to stay connected.